Apple's next big product, the VR headset. The rumor mill is churning once again, with Apple's new VR and AR devices speculated to hit the market in the next few years. Will they be Apple's next big thing? Here is Apple's VR headset. If you're a subscriber, well, welcome back. But if you're new to the channel, make sure to click the subscribe button to stay up to date with all our engaging videos, and use that trigger finger by smashing that like button. Now, let's get into it! Much has been said in the past couple of months about the Apple Car. Some Apple enthusiasts have welcomed the rumored launch of the new product, speculated to happen no sooner than 2024, as the company's next big thing. But it is likely that between now and then, brand new devices will hit the market first. A new report on the development of a VR, virtual reality headset, and AR, augmented reality glasses, has just made it to the news feed. According to Bloomberg, Apple is planning to launch an expensive, niche, virtual reality headset ahead of its widely rumored AR smart glasses. The first version will be so expensive that each Apple store might only sell one each day. Apple's wearable device would not be novel the same way that the iPhone was a pioneer in the smartphone category. Currently, the likes of HTC, Sony, and Facebook already compete in the VR space with devices like the Oculus. However, should Bloomberg be correct, Apple's VR product would likely be better, more powerful, and accessible only to those willing to spend substantially more to own a VR device. The Apple VR and mixed reality headsets may not be the futuristic Apple glasses that have been rumored, but they are the next best thing. The headset is much closer to the best VR headsets of today, but it will also be the first step toward the augmented reality future Apple seems to be aiming for. Plus, it will release a long time before Apple glasses do. Plenty of rumors have been circulating about the Apple VR and mixed reality headset this past year. But the current consensus seems to be that this is still focused more on the AR side of things than VR. It's also not going to be the kind of thing you're likely to buy on impulse if the pricing rumors are accurate. Apple's VR and mixed reality headset could arrive as early as next year and is set to prepare developers for the launch of Apple Glasses a few years down the line. But, in an uncharacteristic move, Apple apparently won't be attempting to make its headset appeal to a larger audience. By launching the headset ahead of Apple Glasses, it gives developers the opportunity to develop AR apps ahead of time. That way, there are plenty of apps available by the time the AR lenses arrive. That's why it's a mixed reality headset, rather than just a pure virtual reality affair. According to a very large report by Bloomberg's Mark Gurman back in January, Apple's VR and mixed reality headset is due to arrive sometime in 2022. According to Gurman, the headset was in the late prototype stage. That was later corroborated by analyst Ming-Chi Kuo, who has predicted a mid-2022 launch date for the headset. Kuo didn't elaborate any further, but it means that we aren't far away from seeing Apple's very first headset potentially hit stores. The only question we have is, why mid-2022? Perhaps Apple wants to get the headset out into the world before the iPhone 14, so as not to steal the handset's thunder. And if Apple's VR headset really isn't designed for mass market appeal, Apple may well be planning to launch without all the usual fanfare of a large-scale launch event. According to reports, the Apple VR and mixed reality headset is designed to be a precursor to Apple Glass. The AR lenses are supposed to offer an optical, see-through AR experience, according to Ming-Chi Kuo. In other words, based on everything we've heard, Apple Glass is designed to look and act like an ordinary, lightweight pair of glasses. We're talking about glasses that are able to project information, and presumably imagery, onto its lenses. The Apple VR and mixed reality headset is expected to be like a typical VR headset, but one with a number of exterior cameras and sensors that unlock bonus functionality. That way, Apple's VR and mixed reality headset can offer body tracking and incorporate real-world environments in a virtual space. Plus, the Apple VR headset could incorporate a see-through experience that can deliver a form of augmented reality. So it's not quite like the Oculus Quest 2, which is VR only. Reports on the Apple VR and mixed reality headset price have been mixed, but rumors suggest a developer focus, so pricing may center around attracting programmers. Tim Cook has spoken at length about how AR is Apple's end goal. The headset is reported to be in the first stage in the company's wearable AR ambitions. The headset's main goal is reportedly to prepare developers for the launch of Apple Glass and ensure the specs have app support for launch. Apple's main incentive is not to make money, and reports claim the headset's price will reflect that. While Apple's VR and mixed reality headset is supposed to be expensive, reports are divided on how expensive it's set to be. A report from The Information claims that Apple's VR headset will be as high as $3,000. Gaming VR headsets rarely cost more than $1,000, though the Microsoft HoloLens 2 does cost a whopping $3,500. However, Ming-Chi Kuo has predicted that the headset will only cost $1,000, or the same as the iPhone 12 Pro. While this is still expensive, it's a lot more palatable for the average developer, especially if the headset is as high-powered as reports have indicated. In either case, the cost of entry is going to be high, and certainly a lot higher than other standalone VR headsets. For example, the Oculus Quest 2 costs just $300. The main feature of the Apple headset is mixed reality. According to Mark Gurman, the headset will include external cameras, which are currently being used to test features like hand tracking and gesture control. Part of this includes the possibility of being able to type in the air with a virtual keyboard. The Information's report has elaborated on this, claiming the headset will feature 12 tracking cameras that can feed information to two 8K displays in front of the user's eyes. On top of that, the headset will also reportedly feature LiDAR sensors. For those that don't know, LiDAR uses lasers to measure distance, which can gather the area of a space quickly and accurately. A device can use this info to better place objects in AR, and has already been used this way on high-end iPad Pro as well as the iPhone 12 Pro and iPhone 12 Pro Max. However, all those sensors may not be working alone. Sources have told The Information that users will be able to wear a thimble-like device on their finger to help with hand tracking and other controls. A lot of power is going to be needed to keep all this going, and Gurman's report claims that the headset will feature Apple's most advanced and powerful chips. Apparently, the chip inside Apple's VR headset will be more powerful than the newly launched M1 Mac chip. A patent discovered by Apple Insider reveals that Apple has been working on some smart rings, which can be used to track finger and hand movements. This could be employed with the VR and mixed reality headsets to boost the capabilities of the external cameras. The patent also mentions being able to detect objects the user is holding, including an Apple Pencil. That means the headset will be able to see what you want to do and alter its functionality accordingly. Apple originally planned to include less powerful processors and offload much of the work to a hub in a user's home that would wirelessly beam content to the headset, but that idea was squashed by Jony Ive, Apple's design chief at the time, Bloomberg News reported last year. The headset is designed to work as a standalone device, meaning it can operate on a battery rather than be plugged into a wall or a Mac. That's similar to Facebook's latest VR product, while Sony's requires a PlayStation gaming console. The COVID-19 pandemic has disrupted some development, with Apple hardware engineers only being able to work on certain days from the office. The company has also faced delays conducting user testing and data collection. That has slowed some decisions in the engineering process. What do you think of Apple's new product? Let us know in the comments section below. And hey, if you've enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel so we can continue giving you the best content. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.